This is referred to as the bladesmith's performance test. The test involves four very simple steps. First of all, the knife has got to sever a free-hanging 1-inch sisal rope. The purpose of that part of the test is to test the edge geometry and the sharpness of that knife. In order for the knife to successfully sever the rope, it's got to be ground thin and it's got to be sharp. It has been known that a rope has been cut with a brass knife before, so this doesn't actually test the heat treat at all. This is edge geometry and sharpness. So it forces the bladesmith to make the knife thin. The part directly following that is the wood chopping. Now the purpose of the wood chopping is to test the heat treat of the knife. Has the edge been hardened sufficiently to maintain an edge and still keep a shaving sharpness quality to it at the end? The fact that the knife had to be thin for the rope cut is kind of contradictory to what is required for the wood chop, because now you're using the knife like an axe, and those impact forces are very severe and heavy on a thin blade. So if your knife is too hard and brittle, it's going to chip out. If your knife hasn't been hardened sufficiently, it's not going to shave, and you're going to find maybe the edge wrinkles or rolls over. So any deformation or nicks or chips to the cutting edge, it's an immediate failure. Following the wood chop, it's an arm hair shave or back hair. Okay, so the arm hair qualifies the heat treat after chopping. The last part of the test is to prove that the bladesmith is able to do a differential heat treatment, which involves making the edge hard and the spine tough. The knife gets bent in a vise through 90 degrees. Ideally, it should not snap or crack. However, the rules do allow for a crack to propagate no further than 1/3 across the width of the knife. If the knife breaks, one will analyze the grain structure and the hardness and so forth, and one is certainly wanting to learn from this experience. And those knives that make it, how were they done? Those that didn't make it, what's the reason for that? So if your knife's a failure, consider it part of everyone's learning experience. The two tests that we're going to be doing today is the first step en route to membership to the South African Guild if you are going to be submitting forged carbon steel knives. You have to pass the performance test before you can proceed with submitting knives to the Guild. As for Neels, Heather and I, this is the first journeyman smith performance test that we are conducting on our own. We've been willing witnesses to a performance test in Montana, and that chappie had his certificate signed by, I think, 5 master smiths. So Neels, thanks for that privilege you're giving us.
No, thank you.
And we are very pleased that you are taking your bladesmithing as seriously as you are. Neels, to qualify for the journeyman smith test, has had to be an ABS member already for 2 years. So it's not just a case of fall out of the sky and decide you're going to test. You know, you had to decide this 2 years ago. So, yeah, well done. Okay, who's going to go first? Neels.
Apparently I am.
Yes. Okay. Now, just as far as the safety aspects are concerned, as far as the rope cutting and wood chopping, the non-chopping hand, let's say you're left or right-handed, is going to grab your belt at the back here. Because what has happened in the past, guys are chopping like this, and the other hand is swinging around, it's in the way, and the knife either glances off the wood or the follow through with the rope cut. Hands get cut and shins have been chopped. So we want none of that. So the non-cutting hand holds your belt. The off-hand leg is back. And that is the correct stance for the rope cut. The whole reason that the shin was chopped was he was standing this way. And he whacked through the rope, and the heavy mass and momentum of that knife put it into his shin, probably down to the marrow bone. Okay. First of all, we need to test the knife. As far as size specification is concerned,
and Neels needs to do a breathalyzer test too. Because he just asked me for 500 mils of whiskey. And then he changed that to museum wax. Okay,
so for the record, the blade may be no longer than 10 inches, and we've got here 9 3/4. Remember, this is an American test, so we're measuring inches now. 9 3/4. It may not be longer overall than 15 inches, and now that is measuring 14 1/4 inch. Maybe no wider than 2 inches, and we've got 1 3/4. So it's within thickness. Limits all over.
Thickness.
Okay.
Okay then.
Now, right. Nice follow through. Whippy wrist.
You were building the tension.
That would have been, see, that would have been me crying.
That's a big piece of wood. How the world record is 1.1.
Nice wide knee, Neels.
Working on that. Being fine.
Right, let's spin it around.
Go somewhere. So yes, let's turn it around so you can catch your breath.
Yes, it starts with jamming up in the bottom of the
wheel. Should have had a
stopping and nothing is happening.
Neels, you should have had a smoke before you started.
Should have had two.
And that 500 mils.
That's not a small chunk of wood, eh? And you gotta do it twice more.
Definitely harder than what I practiced.
Hey!
You wanna rest? You don't have to.
That's good.
It's not a race.
Yes, you need to keep that piece of wood, Neels.
Yes. Is that good position?
That's good.
Okay.
Even the birds are nervous.
Yeah. I would be as well with my neck, which that's
lady's worried about it.
It's an unusual punishment. Well, you have to have a second because you're interrupting the
soldier. Have a rest.
Can you nominate someone to do the fucking points?
You've got a big fellow here from.
Yeah, I've got my own. Your knife's bigger than the one that I have to chip with. In your own time, exterminate. Listen to the robot. Exterminate.
I'm trying.
Come on.
You know what this is, Neels? You don't spend enough time forging. Man. You don't spend enough time forging.
But if I spent this much forging, then I'm definitely doing something wrong.
Yeah.
Okay, now you must shave with the part of the knife that was most used for chopping. So that zone there.
Thank you, sir.
Catch your breath and then.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Neil Paulson.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
That's nice. Okay, so I'm going to indicate once 90 degrees has been reached.
Slow and steady.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Well done. What is nice to see that this blade didn't get a kink in it, and that it's got a measure of spring back to it. That's a good bit. Right, now this knife may not be modified in any way from now until next year Blade Show Atlanta.
Perfect.
Okay. Aside from a bit of museum weights. Lots of photos.
Now it's a corner cutter.
Okay, that is a successful test.